Hannah is a board-certified music therapist. Her work focuses on evidence-based use of music to help patients and their families cope with emotional, physical, and psychological impacts of illness, with the ultimate focus on improving well-being and the quality of life, which all of us, as no matter what we're going through in our life, we would all love that. So I am going to pass the baton on to Hannah, and then I'll come back for just a second at the end. Hannah?
Awesome. All right, I will share my screen here. I have a slideshow. Let's see. There we go. Get us into the slideshow. All right. So I'm calling the program tonight, Tap Your Toes and Sing Your Song, Music and Movement to Support Wellness. So I'll talk somewhat briefly and then I'll just get us into the music. But in terms of why we're doing this, why music, why is it useful? There's so many reasons, but one that I want to talk about is that it's processed throughout the brain. So one thing that we love about music is it activates so many different brain regions: memory, emotion, movement, communication. Those are just a few. And it can help to build new pathways between those areas. It's one of the few things that really can activate that many parts of the brain. So it's both an individual experience with yourself, just, you know, enjoying your music, and it can also be so social, enjoying music with others. It can really meet you where you are, right? So there's so many different types of music, and you can find the kind that, you know, matches the mood you're in or the energy level you have at that moment and maybe help you shift. And it's accessible by all ages, all abilities. So it's just such an accessible tool in that way. So just to name a few of the positive benefits we get when engaging with music, it can release those feel-good hormones to help make us feel better, help us connect with joy, can lower our heart rate and our blood pressure to help us relax. It can help us express our emotions, can help us connect to those meaningful memories, right? The song bringing us back to that place we were when we first heard it. And of course, it can motivate movement. So that's definitely one of the ones we'll focus on for a good amount today. So in terms of finding our way into music today, I'm going to offer some different ways in, and then we'll get into it. And I did want to focus on movement while singing and while engaging with music. I mean, partly because it's the middle of winter, it's cold, you know, we want to see if we can move a little bit, kind of create some warmth. And also we're at this point in this pandemic where we may have had, you know, spent more time at home, more time inside. So just connecting us with, you know, this experience of really just moving our bodies and all the good that can come with that. So our bodies naturally want to move to music. So this is just a given. You might have had that experience where a song comes on and all of a sudden you realize that your toes are tapping away and you're not thinking about it. They just are, because they naturally want to move to the beat. So here are some ways that we might move tonight. It doesn't have to be getting up and, you know, dancing all big if that's not where you're at today. It can be breathing along to the music, just taking those nice deep breaths. It can be stretching to the music if you feel like you need a little bit of some shoulder rolls, some neck rolls. It can be swaying, right? So just letting the flow, the beat of the music kind of help you sway back and forth. Of course, you can tap your feet, and then what I talk about is moving that beat throughout your body. Often it'll start with our feet, but you can take that tap, that, and move it, oh, maybe to your knees by patting your knees, maybe to your shoulders, bop, 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 maybe you bop in your head, right? So just seeing what it feels like to move that beat that often starts down there with our toes, just throughout your body into different places. Maybe it comes into your fingers and you're snapping. Maybe it comes into your hands and you're clapping, right? Maybe the table in front of you becomes a drum. All these options. And follow and lead with movements, right? So sometimes you might be seeing the person next to you adding a movement. You can kind of take that one and go with that, or you might come up with something that feels good and someone else might be inspired by that. So here's kind of those, you know, some ways into the music today, and let's try it. So you might see Curtis Mayfield and the impressions up there on that screen. And now, let's see, I'm back spotlighted, right? You guys can see me all right? Good. Okay, so let me go like this. I am gonna warm us up a little bit and then we'll get into some singing and some moving. So here we go. There we go. All right. So I'm gonna bring the guitar in. And wherever we are, I'm gonna invite us to take a second and sort of shift your body until you find a comfortable spot. And maybe we'll take a couple deep breaths along with the music just to kind of arrive and land. So I'll guide us through that so we can breathe in like this. And out. I'll do that again, breathing in. Yeah. And maybe adding a little bit of those stretches. So it's going to be hard for me to demonstrate with the guitar in my hands, but if you want to just stretch your arms to one side and back. Yeah. And stretch your arm to the other side. Yeah, Judy's demonstrating for us. Thanks. And back. And maybe we stretch it up back to this side again. And back. Mm-hmm. One more to the other side. And back. And maybe we'll stretch up tall if that feels good. And back down. Any other stretches that are feeling good right now, just whatever is kind of your body's telling you to do. And then I'm gonna bring in a little bit of a hum just to wake up our voices. So we'll hum like this. And again, you can stay muted, but the beauty of singing on Zoom is you don't have to worry. You're just in your space. You can sing out and just enjoy singing. All right, so we'll hum a little bit just to start like this. We're gonna go. So just a gentle hum. Feeling that hum in your body. Let's open the hum up to an ooh. Ooh. Try that again. Ooh. How about an oh? Oh. And as you can see, I'm swaying back and forth. You can do that too. Oh. Now we'll open it up to an ah, nice and big. Ah. Awesome. Ah. We'll do two more like that. Ah. Notice where you feel it in your body. Is it in your toes, like I mentioned? Or maybe it's in your fingers. Just find that beat. Tapping along. And I'm going to bring us into a song by The Impressions called It's All Right, but we got to keep the beat going while I share my screen again. Sorry about that. Keep it going, keep it going. All right, we're gonna start with the chorus. on the right of the screen where it says, "Say it's all right." This is kind of a repeat after me song if you don't know it. So it goes like this. Say it's all right. It's all right. Say it's all right. It's all right. Awesome. The next part goes like this. It goes, "It's all right. Have a good time. 'Cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right." We'll do that. "It's all right. Have a good time. 'Cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right." All right, you're still feeling that beat in your toes or your hands on your knees. We'll do the chorus again. Say it's all right. It's all right. Say it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. Have a good time, 'cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. Awesome. Now the first verse over on the left actually gives us some movement prompts right there in the lyrics. So we'll try that together. Start from where it says, "Now listen to the beat." Here we go. Now listen to the beat, listen to the beat. Kinda pat your feet, kinda pat your feet. Well, you got soul, everybody knows. That it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. Come on and clap your hands. Come on and clap your hands. Give yourself a chance. Give yourself a chance. Well, you got soul. Everybody knows that it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. Yeah. You can keep those hands clapping if that feels good. And there's a little bridge here that you can even hum maybe along with me while I sing it. It goes like this. When you wake up early in the morning, feeling sad like so many of us do, well, hum a little soul, make life your goal, and surely something's gotta come to you. Back to the chorus. Said it's all right, it's all right. Said it's all right, it's all right. It's all right, have a good time, 'cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. La-da-da-da. La-da-da-da. La-da-da. La-da-da. Ba-da-ba-ba-da-da-da. We'll do the chorus one more time, mellowing it out a little bit. Here we go. Say it's all right. Mm-mm-mm. Say it's all right. Mm-mm-mm. Well, it's all right. Have a good time. 'Cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. Yeah, it's all right. Have a good time. 'Cause it's all right. Whoa, it's all right. All right. So I thought that one could be a good sort of theme song for us tonight because it gives us those prompts, those reminders to clap our hands, to feel that beat, pat our feet, etc. So I'm going to keep it moving along. This next one I know people will know. Oh, there we go. Fly Me to the Moon. Let me move this out of the way here. It says written by Bart Howard, but I know a lot of us know it as a Frank Sinatra tune. I did put these little movement prompts in the corner. So for this one, it's more of a jazzy tune, right? So it has a kind of a swing feel. So I put up here, turn your knees into drums. So if we think about... So you might just see what it feels like to... Let's see, I'm doing it out of view here, but I'm patting on my guitar, and you can do that same sort of patting on your knees as if you're kind of the drummer, the jazz drummer for this tune, and just see what that feels like. All right. Let's see. So get those knee drums going as they're bringing us into the intro here. start with Fly Me to the Moon. Here we go. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my head. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart. Here we go. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. This time I'm gonna go through it on ba-da-da. So this is the drum solo and voice solo break. Here we go. Ba-da-da-da-ba, ba-da-ba-ba, ba-do-do-do. Keep those knees going. Ba-da-do-do-do, ba-do-do-da-do-do-do-do. Ba-ba-ba, la-da-da, la-da-da-da-da. Ba-da-ba-ba. Fill my heart with song. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. Maybe we can go, oh, in other words. One more time. Oh, in other words, I love you. Do, 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 do. You can do a drum roll on your knees. All right. So I'm trying to give us a chance to try some music with different feels. So that one brought a little bit more of that jazz, that swing feel. And then I'm going to bring us right along into Morning Has Broken by Cat Stevens, who I think now goes by Yusuf. So this might be a familiar one too, and it definitely slows it down a little bit. And it's actually in what we call a 3-4 time signature. So if you've done a little bit with, if you've played instruments before, you might have heard that. So that's this idea. It's also often called a waltz. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So instead of having four beats, which many songs will use, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, this one is in these patterns of three, and it gives it this sort of rocking motion. So I want to prompt us with this one to actually take up some space while we rock and sort of swing our arms back and forth. This is also, you know, a song about the morning. So this is one that I might offer, you might try in the morning to kind of wake up a little bit, swinging your arms back and forth. So really, you know, kind of taking up space and using that waltz feel to bring in that rock. So I'm gonna just take a little sip of water. All right. So I'll just get into the feel of it first. So you kind of feel that rock. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. So we'll start with the words, morning has broken. Here we go.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird.
You can do some bird arms there, yeah.
Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them swinging fresh from the wood.
Next verse.
sweet the rain's new fall, sun made from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass.
We'll go on to the next verse.
Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play.
Here we go.
Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day.
This time we'll do it on La, so you can kind of let the words go and just see what it feels like to keep those sways with those nice big arm motions going with some La's. Here we go.
La da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da da da. La da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da da da.
We'll do the first verse one more time.
Morning has broken like the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
Last line.
Praise for them springing fresh from the world.
All right. Maybe after doing several songs in a row, we could take a little stretch break. Maybe take a couple of those deep breaths that we did at the beginning. If you have water or tea nearby, you can grab a sip of that. On to the next one here. Ah, we got some Beatles coming up. So I thought I'd bring in this Beatles classic, All You Need Is Love. And I thought we can get kind of playful with this one. So the chorus, you know, repeats that line, all you need is love. So what I was thinking is maybe we can even practice ahead of time that we can do something like nice big open arms for all you need. All you need is love. And bringing our hands to our heart for love. Or if you're feeling more of a making a little heart with your hands because we're on Zoom and that kind of looks cool, you can do that too. But something like when we get to that chorus, all you need is love. Oh, and then you can add a little air trumpet. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need, etc. So when we get to that part, just see what it feels like to kind of bring in some of those hand motions, and we will get to it. Take one more sip here. This is also a good one just for some toe tapping. So we'll start with that part that just goes love, love, love right at the beginning, right? But I'll go through the chords one more time.
Praise
well. Love, love, love. Love, love, love. Bum, bum. Love, love, love. Bum, bum. Love, 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 love. We'll do that again. Here we go. Love. Try the verses here. There's nothing you can do. There's nothing you can do that can't be done. Nothing you can sing that can't be sung. There's nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. They fit a lot of words in there, right? We can do it. Here we go. There's nothing you can make that can't be made. Now no one you can save that can't be saved. There's nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time. It's easy. All right, here comes our chorus. Big arms. All you need is love. All you need is love. La da 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 da. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. Yeah. Love, love, love. Love. I like that part. It's kind of like a little reset. We get to just sort of breathe and not worry about too many words. Just repeat that one word, love, love, love.
Love, 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 love.
We'll try the third verse down there. There's nothing you can know. There's nothing you can know that isn't known. Nothing you can see that isn't shown. There's nowhere you can be that isn't where you're meant to be. It's easy. All right, we'll go to the chorus now with those motions. All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. Chorus again. All you need is love. Everybody. What do they do? All you need is love. All together. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need.
All right, back to our
love, love, love.
Love, love, love. Love, love, love. Love.
But just humming. I once heard someone say that humming is almost like a little massage from the inside. It just kind of sends those little vibrations and sort of that sense of kind of soothing relaxation. So we'll do a little bit more humming on those, that little intro. See how it feels. Close your eyes if that feels good. All right, some Beatles. So, let me see where I'm at, because I have a little bit of talking to do at the end here. Ooh, this is a great song. We'll just go through this one real quick before we get to the talking, because I love this song. So maybe the last song we'll do before a little bit more is, I always thought of it as feeling groovy, and then I realized that it was actually called the 59th Street Bridge Song. But the main line that repeats is that. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. Feeling groovy. I saw some people singing that along right away. Yep. All right. So, looks like for the movement prompt, I just said move those feet. So this one even has that line about kicking down the cobblestones, right? So this is one where you kind of might see what it feels like to just tap your toes along or even pick up your feet as kind of like a march, if that feels good too. And we'll see how it goes. Start with slow down, you move too fast. Here we go. Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last, just kicking down the cobblestones. Looking for fun and feeling groovy. Anyone can do this part. Here we go. Ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. We'll do that line again. Ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. All right, between verses, bring those feet back in, just a little tapping or marching. Here's the next verse. Here we go.
Hello, lamppost. What you knowing? I've come to watch your flowers growing. Ain't you got no rhymes for me? Do-do-do, feeling groovy. Ba-da-da-da-da-da.
Also a good one for a snap, I'm realizing. Like, snap, 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 yeah, snap. All right, we'll try the last verse. They fit in a lot of words in this one, too. Here we go. We'll give it a try. I got no deeds to do, no promises to keep. I'm dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you. All is groovy. Ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. You can let this part kind of go and be creative with it too. We'll do a little bit more just ba da da. So you could go ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. Or you can start up high and you can go
ba da 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 da.
Just making it up as you go and see what comes out. La da do di da do da do ba ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. Two more times that line. Ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. Last time, here we go. Ba da 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 da. Feeling groovy. Can you give me a drum roll wherever you are? Yeah. Awesome. All right. So let me stop my screen share for a minute here. Now I can see all your lovely faces. There we go. So I want to try. One other thing here, in addition to these, and there was one other, okay, I'm changing my mind. I'm going to teach us a song real quick. There's one more song that is not very well known, but I love it, and it's all about kind of moving. It's called Let Life Move Me by a songwriter named Sean Grace. And I'm going to actually do this one without my guitar, and it might just be a little bit of a sort of a cappella movement piece here. So you see the words right there, but I'll still do it call and response so you can hear how each line goes. And we'll just try something new. So I'm going to sing it one time through from the top so you get a feel for it, and then I'll do it line by line. All right. So the feel is something like this. It has a hum. So you might get your feet marching to that. Yeah. Da, da, da. Ba, ba, ba. Ba, ba, ba. I see some people moving. Yeah. Ba, ba, ba. All right, I'm singing it from the top. See, so you know how it goes, like this. I'm gonna let life move me. I'm gonna let life stir me deep. I'm gonna let life wake me from an ancient sleep. I'm gonna laugh all my laughter. I'm gonna cry all my tears. I'm gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. That's the whole song. Can you guys hear my feet stomping? Good, okay. All right, I'm gonna do it line by line. Here it goes. I'm gonna let life move me. Try that. I'm gonna let life move me. Then it goes. Gonna let life stir me deep. Try that. Gonna let life stir me deep. Then it goes. I'm gonna let life wake me from an ancient sleep. Try that. Gonna let life wake me from an ancient sleep. Then it goes. I'm gonna laugh all my laughter. Try that. Gonna laugh all my laughter. I'm gonna cry all my tears. I'm gonna cry all my tears. I'm gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. I'm gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. Yeah. All right, we'll do it from the top again, and this time we might add some motions. You might have seen me doing some of them. I'm just kind of making it up, but it follows the words there. All right, gonna let life move me. Ready? We'll do it in 1, 2. Here we go. I'm gonna let life move me, stir me deep. I'm gonna let life stir me deep, wake me. I'm gonna let life wake me from an ancient sleep. Gonna laugh. I'm gonna laugh all my laughter. Gonna cry. Gonna cry all my tears. Love the rain. Gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. Back to the hum. Or just pause and catch your breath while I hum. We'll do it one more time from the top. Here we go. I'm gonna let life move me, stir me. I'm gonna let life stir me deep, wake me. I'm gonna let life wake me from an ancient sleep. Gonna laugh. I'm gonna laugh all my laughter. Gonna cry. Gonna cry all my tears. I'm gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. That line again. Gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. Last time. I'm gonna love the rain as deeply as the sun when it clears. All right. So a lovely tune that always gets me moving. And let's see. I think I am going to shift us into a little bit more talk, and I want to just give us some really tangible things that we can do at home with music daily, depending on what we need. So I'm gonna, let's see, share my screen for that, and then we'll go from there. All right. So, tips for using music at home. we do a lot of this just naturally, but as a music therapist, there's certain things that, you know, I might be able to offer that you might have never tried or might not have thought about, and you can see how you can incorporate it into your daily routine. So I'm going to organize it by, you know, the goal. So the first one being music to relax and find comfort. So how are we going to use music for that goal? You can create a playlist of your favorite calming music just to kind of have it ready in one place. If you're new to playlists, I do actually have some handouts that show you how to do it on different platforms like Amazon Music or Spotify or some of those different programs. So my email will be at the end, and feel free to reach out, and I'm happy to connect you with some of that. But then once you have that calming music on, close your eyes and allow the music to evoke maybe some peaceful imagery. This can work really well with instrumental music too. So putting on maybe something classical or something instrumental and just seeing what images come to mind that are kind of evoked by the music. This goes right with what we were talking about today, but just breathe, stretch, sway along with that calming music. This is one of my favorites. Pair it with something else that you love to do, like drawing, knitting, doing a puzzle, going on a walk maybe once it gets a little bit warmer, gardening once spring is here, any of that, other kinds of art making. So just, you know, kind of combining that calming music with something to do with your hands that just kind of keeps you present, helps you relax. So those are some of my favorite tips in terms of relaxation and comfort. I'll go along here, music to connect and engage. So in terms of all the social aspects of music, oops, there we go. So with a loved one, listen to favorite music together and share the stories that it evokes, right? So we often, oh, this song makes me think of this, or, oh, I forgot, remember that time that we went to see this? So just kind of let the music bring out those memories and those stories. This one also fits with what we were talking about tonight. Take turns leading and following movements along to the music. So if one of you's like, ooh, this is a nice one for shoulders, the other person can join in and add some shoulders. Or just get up and dance, have a kitchen dance party or a living room dance party. And this one, just kind of using YouTube as a resource, there's so many live performances, music videos, even karaoke sing-alongs where it has the lyrics at the bottom of the screen. So it can just be a really nice activity from your couch, you know, with a computer, pulling up YouTube and typing in, you know, karaoke version of, and then put in your favorite song and just sing along with that, or watch a live performance. So different ways to kind of just use the music together. Music to modify your mood. So definitely can be something that you go to when you're feeling sad and down or stressed and overwhelmed. And what I often say is that, and it says here, you can choose music that matches your mood. And sometimes that's what we need. We actually need some sad songs to kind of meet us right where we are, maybe help us get out a good cry. Other times we might be looking for the music to help us actually shift to a different place. So maybe you've gotten out that cry and you're like, I think I'm ready to pick it up a little. So then see if the music might maybe have a little bit more of an uplifting feel, or some lyrics that you find hopeful or encouraging, right? So you get to choose. Do I need the music to kind of meet me where I am for a little bit, or do I need it to help me shift to somewhere else? This, you know, similar to kind of when you're using music for relaxation, you can maybe think about some journaling or some art making. If you feel like, you know, you need to kind of get out some of a certain emotion, and the journaling or the art making can kind of help sort of express that along with the music. And then lastly, music to energize and motivate. So some of the movement stuff we were doing today can go right along with using music to energize. But again, having a playlist of your favorite upbeat songs, and then just kind of listening to it and seeing how you want to move along with it. Again, what we were doing today, maybe finding something you can drum along. Or my favorite, see if your playlist can make not so fun tasks more enjoyable, right? So if you put on some great upbeat songs that make you smile, make you move, and then do something you don't really want to do, like clean the house or do the dishes or organize something, the music might just make it go on along a little faster, a little more enjoyable. So that is that. Okay. I think before we do a dance break, I want us to end with just an actual, not me on guitar, but maybe a recorded song to move a little bit. But maybe I will shift at this point to open it up for any questions or comments before we go into a little bit of a little kind of dancing out.
Anybody have any thoughts or questions that you want to put into the chat box? This would be a great time to do that. Anna, can you just tell us just for a second about how you learned to be a music therapist?
Yeah, sure. So I think music therapists often find it in all sorts of different ways. I was more in the music education world, teaching music, and then I, at some point along the way, realized that I was less interested in actually teaching the music skills, like the specifics of the technique and the scales and all of that, and more interested in everything else that could come with the process of engaging with music and the social emotional learning, or the emotional expression, or, you know, shifting in mood, all of that. And I realized, oh, you know, there's actually a field where they use music for those goals. So I ended up getting a master's in music therapy, and our training involves a lot of psychology, we look at music and the brain. We bring in some aspects of, you know, mental health counseling. So we're using some verbal counseling techniques, but then also using the music. We do a lot of, you know, training on different instruments so that we're kind of ready to be flexible with the music and to kind of meet each person where they are in terms of how they're looking to use music, whether they want to do some listening for relaxation, whether they want to jump right in and sing along or try a new instrument, do some songwriting. So, yeah.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's one chat. Let's look at that. I love playing classical music on my Bose or Apple Music when having my coffee with my partner in the morning. It has become a ritual. It allows us to come from sleep to awakening.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So almost like a transition there, where the music kind of helps you go from that one state to another. And I love thinking of it as a ritual, really, like it's part of starting the day. Yeah. And yes, that question there about those. So I actually will put them on a one pager that maybe I can have you guys email out to any all the.
Yeah, you send that to us and we can send it out to everybody who registered.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And then Jennifer says, this is fantastic. My mom and I loved it. Thank you.
Glad to hear it. Yeah.
I think there's one last song you want to do with us.
Yeah. So I thought I would, let me just get it ready here. I'm going to just give us a chance to what I sometimes think of as like a dance break or just to dance out. You know, to close out with a little bit more movement. So I'm going to put on a song that I love that always makes me tap my toes. And feel free to actually get up if you feel like getting out of your chair and moving around. I might do that, so you might see me dance around a little bit here. But I'm going to share my sound. So you'll really just... Oh, and I was going to say, at this point, if we want to put it on gallery view so we can see each other moving... then that might be one thing to do because it can kind of, you can be inspired by all of our little boxes moving together on the screen. But
and if anyone who is now not showing their video would like to show their video, not to be embarrassed, but just to share in the fun, this would be the moment.
And this part won't be included in any recording that's posted, right? So you can feel free to just, you know, open your camera and just join in,
right,
in the fun if you'd like, and there's no pressure. All right, so I'm not going to even say what song it is. I'm just going to share my sound here. And let's see. Computer audio, there we go. I hope it's not too loud, so I'm going to start it kind of soft and I'll fade it in. Can we hear that okay? So it's a little Stevie Wonder.
Like a fool I went and stayed too long. I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Mm-hmm. find my way.